excited, and I have prepared a different video for you today. As you can see, I changed my workspace, and I will walk you through what I have done and how it started. In October, I participated in the Inktober challenge. I have only filmed 3 of these illustrations. While I was painting them, I knew I will not finish all the month, but I'm happy with the 10 illustrations that I managed to finish. You can see the painting process of them here, and if you want to see all of them, you can go to my Instagram and see them there. So after finishing my Inktober challenge, I was left with a big mess at my office. So last week I started putting things in the right place and cleaning up. I also managed to clean my windows. That is something, at least the cleaning up thing is something that I usually do on the weekends. So I could have a clean and nice office to start up in the coming Monday. Hello, today is Saturday and I have been doing some cleaning up and tidying things up, and I have still a lot of things to do. I have all these things hanging on the walls and I want to do something about it. So my husband has just went out to buy a big board and we will make a shelf here behind, so I can put all the original paintings in a place where they can't be ruined or don't get too much sunlight and stuff like that. So that is what I'm doing right now. So I have to remove all the things hanging on the walls and tidying things up a little bit. So here, as you can see, I have some of the Inktober paintings that I did. Just some of them. I have already flattened out some of them. And here we have some of the subjects that I painted. Here I have some candy and my daughter's art supplies and books and the Inktober list and lots of stuff. We have been painting last weekend. We have a week's of vacation right now, so my daughter and me, we took a day of painting. Here I have some new art supplies, maybe I will show you later. I have packed them out already, I couldn't wait. Yeah, so this is the situation. So as you heard me say, I did also need to take down all the illustrations that I had hanging on the walls, because I was about to get a shelf in the studio where I could place all the original illustrations that I have and keep them safe there. And the same day, a little bit later, I decided to also do some cleaning up, if you can say that, in the computer, because my old computer didn't have almost any space left, so I needed to clean the computer up as well. Next day we managed to set this board up. We actually had to hang it in 6 pairs of chains because one of our walls is very thin. We could not support the board on that side. So we decided that hanging the board on chains would be enough because it only had to have paper on it. So that's what we did. Right now I have them all laying here in the dining room. I have to organize what is going to be on my shop and what is not. Some of these illustrations are only for commercial work, and I don't think anybody would like something like this or like this. Maybe, I don't know, but I will put some of these on my shop. And I have here, you may have seen this, it's huge. Look at my the size of my hand. So this is one that didn't have a place to be in, and I was really afraid that it will get ruined or the cat will go on top of it or anything worse. And here I have a box from some furniture we bought, and here I have all the originals that I have kept. I actually don't throw anything out, so I have a lot. And I was afraid that they would get ruined here because every time I set the box up, not laying down like this, I had it standing up behind my door, and I'm afraid that they will sparkle or get ruined in the bottom of it. So yeah, I'm looking forward to see that, or to have that shelf in the studio. But I didn't stop there. Down the board went again, and I decided that in order to make my office a little bit more cozy to be in, as this wall behind me is always very dark, I decided to buy a pot of paint and paint that back wall. To be finished before my daughter came home from school, but I couldn't, so she kept me company, which also was nice. You always have these funny talks with children. Later the same night, I went into the studio again, put all the furniture in the right place again, and actually also bought 2 new plants, and that is all what I have bought for this little studio makeover, if you can call it that. There's the result, which I'm very, very happy about. The armchair that you see there was a chair that we had in the house that we didn't use, and I was missing a place where I could sit and relax, or just to go a little bit away from the projects I'm working on. And on the armchair there's a pillow with the one of the first client work that I did for a Danish company that printed my illustration on different home decor products. In the wall I have some of my art prints. And then I reorganized my shelf with my sketchbooks and some decoration things and all my color pencils and stuff. And under that I have some cases, some boxes, or what you can call them, with all the paints that I use. And down that I have all other stuff, more paint. I hope you liked my video, and if you did so, please like and share and subscribe to my channel. And if you are interested in buying my art prints or my originals, you can go to marianneschild.dk. You can also subscribe to my newsletter that is in Danish, but sometimes I give a coupon code so you can get things from my shop with a little discount. And if you want the newsletter in English, you can also go to my other website, marianneschild.com, and subscribe to my newsletter there. Other than that, I hope you are doing good, that you are, despite these weird times we are living, please, if you do any decision regarding your health or the health of your loved ones, do your own research and make wise decisions. Have a good day. Until next time.